From Shanghai to Shanghai, Philippine fast food giant Jollibee has announced it has phased out its popular Lumpiang Shanghai. The fried meaty spring roll served with the sweet tangy orange sauce has been a staple among Jollibee lovers. In a statement, the Tan Kak Tiong-led company confirmed that Lumpiang Shanghai is no longer on its menu, but it did not give details on why it phased out the product. Netizens were abuzz with the news, with a Twitter parody account for Chief Presidential Legal Counsel Juan Ponce Enrile joking that the official even outlived the beloved spring roll. Another user also laments inflation is taking away people's value meals. On Facebook, the post from ABS-CBN News received around 14,000 reactions. One user is sad that she only has two rice meal choices left, while another is demanding a valid explanation from Jollibee.
Despite a price cap, rice prices soared to a 14-year high in September. But government insists it can't be concluded that the price ceiling was ineffective. Economic managers also assure Filipinos government is all hands on deck to stop the rise in commodity prices. Lady Vicencio reports.
Headline inflation accelerated to 6.1% in September from 5.3% in August. The Philippine Statistics Authority attributed the rise to food and transport prices increasing at a faster pace. Despite the imposition of a price ceiling, rice inflation ballooned by 17.9%, or more than double the previous month's rice inflation of 8.7%, and the highest in 14 years. But the PSA says rice inflation numbers are inconclusive of the effectivity of the price cap.
Yung first phase ng ating data collection, may mga outlets na nagsasabi na inuubos nila yung stocks, no, dito sa regular and wheel milled rice, kaya nagkaroon ng mas mataas na presyo. Yung second phase, doon nagkaroon ng adjustment, mas marami yung masasabi nating compliant, no?
PSA's second phase monitoring showed that not even half of rice varieties covered by the ceiling were compliant. Average national prices in September were also higher than the price ceiling. Rice Watch Group Bantay Bigas is convinced the price ceiling failed.
Very, very hindi siya effective. Mas ang naging victim nga ay yung mga retailers na makarinig ka talaga sa mga retailers ng hindi na lang ako magbebenta kaysa magpalugi ako. Talagang mangyayari ang napakataas na inflation.
Economist Nicolas Mapa agrees, adding that supply challenges should instead be addressed.
Food inflation was the main, miss that we weren't expecting. Rice inflation at 17.9%, this just tells us that the price caps implemented were not effective.
But the Presidential Communications Office said the economic team is expecting a moderation in rice prices as the harvest season begins. Previous orders of rice imports are also expected to arrive. Finance Secretary Benjamin Jokno assured the public that the administration is all hands on deck when it comes to arresting high commodity prices. Meanwhile, NEDA Secretary Arsenio Balisacan said the government will continue to address long-term supply challenges and support the local agriculture sector. Lady Vicencio, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Agriculture Department appeals to senators to not scrap the agency's 50 million peso confidential fund budget for 2024. Agriculture Assistant Secretary James Layug insists the funding is necessary for going after illegal traders and smugglers. Layug made that statement after Senator Rafi Tulfo said the agency's confidential funding should be reallocated to law enforcement agencies.
So bakit kailangan niyo pa po confidential fund kung smuggling pinag-usapan? Nandiyan naman po ang Bureau of Customs na meron din confidential fund.
Ayon. So may mga quarantine na powers po ang mga FSRA natin, Food Safety Regulation Agencies like BAI, DPI, and PIFAR, and also NMIS, na will also need sana some support para naman mapatibay natin yung mga surveillance operation and ma-reinforce po itong mga accomplishment na nasimulan na rin ng DA po.